I almost didn't get the Pixel because I was salty. I wasn't one of the people Google sent the Pixel out too early. But I do rock with the Pixel heavy. I love stock Android. And this Pixel was only $599 with flagship features. So I had to check it out. Let's jump into this unboxing. Perfect. Alright, so I have the Pixel 6 right here in kinda coral. They got the whole Miami Beach vibe going on, so I had to get this color. I rock with it more than the other colors. This is also the unlocked version because T-Mobile is not carrying it because Verizon has the exclusive on the Pixels right now. So the only other way you can get it is the unlock way, but it was all good. Still got it. But I don't know if it's going to utilize like all of T-Mobile network with their new 5G UC, but that's a whole nother conversation. What's so special about this Pixel 6 is this has Google's own processor in it called Tensor. Supposedly, it's 80% faster than the Pixel 5. I don't know how true that is, but we're gonna find out. Like I said, Pixel's been running on pretty, you know, basic hardware for the longest, and this is also the first year that it's actually having some like flagship specs, got flagship hardware. So I'm interested to check this out, especially with these new upgraded cameras. Pixel have been doing a lot with just very basic camera lenses. So now we have these big boy cameras. Let's see what its processing can do along with some good hardware. Enough talking about it. Let's just open the box and check everything out what's inside. So this is the box. Nothing real special. You see, it's pretty slim. And I wonder why. I guess we can guess why. But got a little quick little pull tab. One. Two little quick pull tabs for the easy unboxing without a knife. I don't know what everybody hate is right now with not letting me use my knife. Everybody want to make these boxes so easy to open up. But this... I ain't gonna lie, I wish it was summertime because this dude gave me that Miami Beach vibe. Made me want to throw on my little peach shorts and and rock out with these. But this is actually, I like it. It's a little vibe. I mean, it's definitely for like the spring, summertime, but this color's a little vibe. Oh, this visor. Oh, this camera. I forgot what they call this little thing, but I'm gonna call it a visor because this thing is huge. Look at the elevation on this. That thing is thick, but it's kind of a little cool though. You see, you got the 50 megapixel camera right here, and also the 12 megapixel wide angle camera. Well, let's peel off the plastic. Got a nice little weight to it. Like, this actually feels premium compared to, well, this is the Pixel 4a 5g. I've been rocking out this one for a little minute, but this just feels cheap. I mean, of course, this is not the flagship version, and it's like what, a year and a half old, but like, look at the difference of this. Like, this look like a premium phone. Like, look at this. This is premium. And you got this. It still got the little fingerprint scanner in the back. So it's like, all right. I actually can't get over how thick this camera housing is. But let's power it on real quick. But before we power it on, you can kind of see the front facing camera right there. The punch hole camera. This thing is pretty thick too. This thing is really thick. It does have a 46 milliamp battery in it. So this battery should last all day, especially with its custom processor. And it has fast wireless charging, fast wire charging, 30 watts. So that's a good addition. Reverse wireless charging. Like, Google really like added everything in this phone to like really make it a flagship this year. But let's just power it up and set it up real quick and actually test it out. I'm really looking forward to testing out the new like camera features, like especially the little Photoshop trick when you just click on something to make it disappear. Like, I'm really excited to test that out. Also, it's some new enhancements to the call screen. You know, I love that call screen because I get a lot of unwarranted phone calls, and I just, nothing more excites me than to like send them people to Google to say, hey, answer this call for me and see what these people want. But I'm going ahead and set this up real quick. Ooh, like making this, oh, that's kind of cool. As this is bouncing right here, it's like vibrating the phone, like you feel like the haptics going off. And that's a cool little, yo, I've been rocking out with the Android 12 on here. And like, I really like Android 12. So I can't wait to like see what the Pixel adding to Android 12 on the Pixel 6. But I'm going ahead and finish setting this up real quick. All right, so after the setup, just got a couple initial impressions just so far. Like, this is, I'm not going to get into too deep with a lot of these things. I'm going to have a full review for that. But first thing, I really do like this design. I like this color. It definitely gives a summertime vibe. But this camera bump is huge. It's like Google seeing the iPhone camera bump was like, oh, that's big. That's cute and all. But hold my beer. And they gave us this crazy big camera bump. I don't have a case for this yet, but it's so thick that I don't even think a case is gonna be thick enough to like hide how huge this bump is. But it does make a nice little, weirdly enough, it makes a nice little resting spot for when you're using your phone. Like, put your index finger right here, like kind of like rest right up under it. Just give you a little better grip. The fingerprint scanner, it's okay. It's a little slow. It's slow. It works, but it's slow. A couple misses. But overall, I mean, it seems to work most of the time. But it's just a half a second. Just too slow. But that display. This display looks really nice. I mean, it gets really bright. It's vibrant. The different wallpapers that comes with this, like, really make this display like pop. And you have a lot of different wallpapers, and like the live wallpapers are pretty cool too, but it's a lot of options for like wallpapers. And not only does it make the display pop, it just changes like the whole like color scheme. I really like this whole Android 12 material U, they're calling it. It gives Android some new life. It's like a really big overhaul of the UI for Android. And I'm really feeling that a whole entire new UI, like everything about it. And it's weird, like at one point in time, like everything was just squared off, and now everything is just round off. And I mean, sure, by another 2-3 years later, it's gonna square everything off again. But it's kind of weird, like it just keeps going back between, we want squared corners or we want rounded corners. But that's that. Also, with the display, it being 90 hertz. Like, I'm glad they didn't skimp out with just the regular Pixel 6 and didn't put a high refresh display on there and just saved it for the Pro. Because the Pro has a 120 hertz display, but the Pixel 6, it has a 90 hertz refresh rate display. And that 90 hertz refresh rate display just makes a huge difference. So Android 12, it's snappy and it's moving. But that 90 hertz display just make it, give it that extra little, that extra buttery smooth to it. The buttons on the Pixel, this might just be me. maybe I'm a little weak, you know, but these buttons seems pretty hard to press. Like, I gotta like really, like it's a whole workout to like click these buttons. They're nice and clicky now. I love that it's clicky. I love that it's tactile. But man, I gotta put some like real force to like press these buttons. One thing I don't like is how they didn't keep like the colored power button. Like right now you can see the power button on here is just black. The power button is black, the volume rocker is black. But you see like this is the Pixel 4a and you can see like how the power button has this like purple to it. Just give it this nice little pop to this like all black rail. You got the volume rocker is black, but you see this purple, blue, whatever color that is, just give the phone an extra little pop to it. Like I would have been really happy if they would have like made the power button like this color right here. I mean in any color, just something other than black, just to just give it the extra little pop to it. Another thing, so I watched like a few videos on here and listened to a little music on here. The speaker, it leaves a little more to be desired. And it's like, it's just my initial impression now. I'm not going to like make a final judgment on it right now. I still need to play around with some settings and stuff, but the speakers, there are dual speakers, stereo speakers, got a speaker on the top, got a speaker at the bottom. But they're like, they seem a little faint to me. Not that loud, not punchy at all. It's just a speaker. The speaker's just there just to be there. Now, the camera. I took a few pictures while I was setting everything up. You know, I had to do my little unboxing selfie, take a picture. But one thing I noticed, like when I'm taking a picture, it takes a good little bit for the picture to process. I mean, you probably didn't notice it that time, but like if I take a quick picture, all right, actually was pretty fast that time. Maybe I see that's why you don't make your final judgments on during an unboxing, because when I was first setting this up, and maybe because I was downloading all of my apps and all of that stuff, the processor was being like worked really hard. Oh man, somebody's really cutting grass right now. But the processor was really worked probably hard, so the picture was taking a good little bit to process. But one thing that is consistent, the viewfinder looks really like grainy while you're looking through it, and like makes like the picture don't seem like it's gonna come out really good. But after you snap the picture, then all the processing happening, the picture comes out really well. And also the magic eraser, that is a cool little feature that works pretty well. Like, I took this picture right here and I used the magic eraser and it came to this. It ain't perfect. You got a little rough around the edges, and probably worked better in different scenarios, but this is like just a quick test. I'm gonna really put it through like a really testing for like a full review. But that magic eraser is cool. And I also want to try out like the little blur effect with like the motion. I think it's like the motion photo. Like you're still, but stuff in your background, it's like it's got some motion. I'm gonna test that out too. I'm looking forward to testing that out. But the camera so far, it looks good, but I don't know, it's blowing me away enough to justify this huge camera hump. Oh man, this camera hump is huge. Like, this is the Pixel 4a, it's almost flat. It's flat for 2021 compared to oh, the camera hump on here is almost as thick as the Pixel 4. I mean, the camera hump is thick. I mean thick. get back to the days when you just had a nice smooth flat back. Yeah. Everybody wants to, everybody's in competition to see who has the biggest camera hump. But that's just coupled first thought. Look at the fingerprint scanner just acting up right now. But yeah, these are just couple first thoughts I had on here. Like this screen looks really, really nice. I'm gonna have a full review coming soon. But this was another Joe Tech Talk. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe button, all that good stuff. It helps the channel out. But I'm gonna catch y'all in the next one. I'm out.